Hey, what's up everyone? So in this one I'm going to make a drawing t-shirt design. As you can see, this is the example I'm going to follow here. I am ready to crush kindergarten. So this theme I am going to recreate here, and I'm going to make something like a dinosaur carrying a backpack and going to school, something like that. So for this design I needed some dinosaur images, so I found this one on Google. This is on some coloringbooks.com, but don't worry, I will draw it and I will combine these items in this, and I hope that will give me a non-copyrighted exclusive content. So let's see how it's done. So first step is I need to draw this, and for drawing an image like this I need to make a custom brush. I'm not using my graphic tablet here today, so I'm just going to do it with my mouse so that you can follow with me. So first step is I am going to make a ellipse here, just a small ellipse like this in black fill, and then I am going to make a new brush, create a new art brush, and then okay. So from here you can simply click this, check this hue shift option that will allow you to change the color of your brush. Click okay. So now I have a brush in my brush panel, I don't need this. Let's delete. And then for this image, I am going to lock this in my layer panel, so it is not going to move from its place. So let's start the design process. So first step is I am going to make sure that this brush is selected, and now I am just going to draw these areas like this. And then of course I will be drawing some other elements that you can see here. And don't worry about the perfection of the design, just keep going. Something like this, and these areas that you can see here, I'm making them intentionally, this area, because just to give it a hand drawing kind of feel. Okay, so I think that is fine. Let's do it one more time. And that much is good. Let's draw this part of the design of the image. And there is a little problem with this brush. You can see the starting and end is a bit thinner, but the center position is thicker. So for combining or joining it with a external or a existing stroke, you can see like this. If I want to join it with this one, then I have to draw. Do not draw from here, just draw from something like this area, and that will make it combine the thickness of the brush. And of course, you can check the setting that you're brush fidelity is all the way, or maybe something like this position you want to keep it. Anyway, just click OK. So that's the option I wanted to show you guys. Now the rest I will be drawing here, but you can okay, let's do it so that you can watch and learn, something like this. Okay, here I have another idea in mind that I will be using a kids show type thing there, so I'm not going to draw that part, something like this. And then here I can simply draw it like this. And then for some of these area I can make the brush size stroke brush size small or bigger however I want, like this. So that's fine. Let's draw it like this. And do not make too long lines, because long lines will make your brush thicker, or the start and finish point will be too thin than the other graphics. So don't make it too long, just make it small, small strokes, like small strokes at a time, like this. That's fine for me. Let's just create. Okay, for this area, as you can see, this is a little smaller than the rest of the graphics. So I can reduce the size of my brush, and then again I can continue the drawing, and that will draw in the smaller size of the brush. Okay, I think that is fine. Let's draw all the inside strokes in this thicker, thin size brush. That's it. something like that. Then for this area, I want to create a shape like this. If I try to make a very pointy end here, you can see like this, it will end up looking like that. Sometimes that's not very good, so that is fine. But for this area, some areas like this, if I try to fix this right now, you can see it will small, it will make this area smaller. So I can do that later. Once my main design is done, I will do that. So I think this is looking good. Let's bring that here and then another copy here. This is just to fill the area, nothing else. So that position is good. I have to make this smaller circles. In a smaller size strokes. Don't worry about the image copyright. We'll change it enough. So here I want to join it with this area. So that is how it is going to be done. And I will be back after making the drawing. Okay guys, so my dinosaur drawing is done right now. As you can see, if I turn off the layer, this is the vector drawing. So maybe I will reduce the size of some of the strokes, like this one, not that much, something like this, and the rest is okay. So I'm going to make it a group first, so that is fine. Now if I need to do any adjustment, like changing anything, I am going to keep a copy here, then select it all, and I am going to then expand it. So expanding it will make it all in fill color, so there is no stroke left. And that's how now I can simply modify my anchor points, sorry, modify the extra areas that is overlapping in my design, and that will be easier for me. So I think this position is not looking very good. Okay, so this one is going outside, so I can simply fix that by using my direct selection tool. And with direct selection tool, I can simply modify that, then select it, press shift M to erase that part. That is looking good, and this is the area. So you can see, if I erase this part now, it is not going to change the size of my stroke. So that's why I didn't do that earlier. And one more thing that I want to share, that in this one I am going to use a very cartoony kids looking dinosaur, because this is a design for kids. So I am not using any scary looking big or something like that dinosaur. So this is just some kids friendly design, I think, and that is a mistake. So let's try to do that. And this one and this one I draw in fill, so they are all in a fill color. Now I can simply unite them to make them on single graphic, but I will lose the ability to edit the design, so I'm not going to do that. Control Z, that means I can still modify or edit my designs here, edit my drawing parts here. So for right now I'm just keeping it editable. So this is the dinosaur part is made. Let's try to place the sunglass on him. So of course in bigger size, so this is the position of the dinosaur, so the sunglass should be in this direction, maybe a bit rotate in this way, and that is fine. But okay, so in this one here I need to do this in two way. So two way means I need to, first of all, I need to draw this part of the sunglass, then I will draw this handle of the sunglass. So how to do that? Let's take our brush tool, and then I'm going to draw this part. Don't worry about the line being very messy, just draw something that looks like a sunglass, something like this. And then of course I'm going to draw another line here, I'm not going to cover all the details of the sunglass. I'm just going to make the basic shape of a sunglass. Just like this, and then once it will be done, I'll be back. Okay guys, so here my sunglass part is done. This is the handle part and this is the glass part. So I'm going to place it something like this so that it looks like the dinosaur is wearing this. So in this position, maybe just like this, or maybe a bit in this direction. So this is just to make it give it a feel like it is wearing a sunglass. It doesn't have to be very realistic or very perfect in position. So this is the glass position here. I'm going to combine or attach it with the sunglass, something like in this position, and then I think it is done. So I need to fix up some areas, you can see here. So first step is I'm going to select these two, and then I'm going to expand appearance, that means making them fill, and then again pressing shift M to adjust this area. So you can see this is how it is looking right now. So I can simply select this part and this part of the sunglass. Okay, so maybe I made a mistake here, so it should be kind of this or like this. Just don't worry about whatever it is. So this position looks good. I just need to fix this area that is overlapping here. So for fixing that, first step is I am going to, so here the sunglass will be on top of my dinosaur, but in this part dinosaur will be on top. So first of all, I'm going to change the color of my dinosaur so that I can see what's going on here. And then if I select my dinosaur, open transparency, make sure you pick the black fill, and with black fill I'm going to draw some random shapes. So whatever I can see inside my sunglass area, I'm going to make them invisible. Okay, not in this part, maybe I do something there, but right now let's hide this part. Of course, hiding this part, and then here the sunglass will be on top. So you can see this is how it is looking. I am not erasing this part and this part because, okay, this part should be hidden because this is the plastic frame, so nothing should be visible from there, but this is the glass part, so it should be visible inside the glass. That's fine, this is good. Now here I am going to select this sunglass, this and this one, making them a group together. Open transparency, and then here I will be hiding this part of the sunglass. It will look like that's the ear of the dinosaur, and then of course this part of the sunglass. So it will look like that part is going beyond the face of the dinosaur, something like this. That is fine. Let's just make everything black, and it is going to look cool. So you can see this is how it is looking right now. So dinosaur is wearing a sunglass. It is not looking very much realistic, but don't worry about this. I'm just going to, it is going to work for me. So this is the dinosaur graphic I wanted to make, and then here I will be making this backpack with the dinosaur. So for making this, again I am going to reduce the opacity so that I can see what's going on here, and then I need to make two part of this backpack. One will be the original backpack, and one will be this belt of the backpack. So I'm selecting my brush tool, again making the opacity down, sorry, the size of the brush down a little bit. Then I'm going to draw some random shapes like this. Don't worry, this is how it is going to look. So maybe from here, I will not need this part because that will be behind the dinosaur. So I just need this upper part of the backpack, something like this. Just try to give it a cool look that it looks like a backpack. I think that much is fine. and again another area from here just to block this open lines. That is fine. So this one I'm going to make it a group and then bring this here. So it will look like the dinosaur is got a backpack on its back, something like this, and that much, that position looks good for me. That is fine. Now I am going to draw this belt part. So I am going to, if I select anything, this object here, it will pick up the stroke size of the brush. Then if I draw anything again, it is going to give me that exact brush size. Okay, so it is not working because this is a custom made brush, but regular brushes work like that, something like this, and then from here it's weird. I'm making a dinosaur carrying a school bag, but this is just to show you guys this is how easily you can make a cool looking or drawing style vector design, t-shirt design. So this is a hook here, I want to keep that. Then this part, I'm not sure if I'll be able to fit this in the design or not, but this part is really important, so I'm going to use that. Maybe I will use these lines here. Okay, so this is the area that I'm going to keep right now. And again, at any point, if I need to make any modifications, I can do that with my direct selection tool, just like this. So that part is done. Let's group it. And here I will be able to, I want to place it something like this, so that it looks like that backpack is, that dinosaur is wearing that backpack. So maybe a bit bigger inside just to match it with that backpack in the background. So that part is done. Let's remove this too. Okay guys, so this is how it is looking right now. I need to do some modifications here, some changes. So for that I'm going to change the stroke color. So this is why I made it in hue shift option of the art brush, so that I can edit this whenever I want. So I'm going to first of all select this backpack group, open transparency, make sure that your fill color is black, and then take your pencil tool just like this, because this area should not be visible if dinosaur is wearing a backpack, something like that. So, and that part is good, I think. So this is how it is looking, and this one there is a little modification because it should be in this direction, because this hand should be on top of that backpack, maybe in this area. So I'm going to erase that, and here I need to do this modifications. So I am using my direct selection tool, and with these anchor points I can modify these anchor points just to match it with the graphics. It can take some time, and of course I'm not a very good artist, so this is really hard for me to make designs like this. Okay, so this much is good for me, looks good to me. Now I will do something here, but for now I am going to, I have to select this one and then open transparency for it, press shift x to make it fill, make sure the fill color is black, and then I am going to take my pencil tool here just to draw a shape like this, because that part should be behind the hand. That is done. And then if I select this dinosaur inside the transparency, I need to make sure that fill color is black, and then I want to hide some part of the dinosaur, like this part of the dinosaur should be in the background of the backpack belt, so it should not be visible. something like this. That is fine, that is cool. Okay, I'm going to erase this part from here. And of course, this part I'm going to erase. So this is how it is looking right now. And I need to do some modifications here. So I'm going to select this one. And then if I pick my brush tool, it is going to, I can again draw here. And then here I will be adding this with the back of the tunnel sort. Don't worry about the proportions or everything. This is not a... Okay, if I need to do erase some part, I can simply go to object expand and then I can simply erase this. I don't need to wait for the stroke mode here. So this is how it can be done. Now if I select this part of the, if I select the dinosaur, I can simply take my pencil tool to hide this part. Okay, so this is how it is looking right now. And I need to take a look here how the backpack looks. It's kind of joined in the background. So I'm going to select that. Then from here I'm going to draw another shape that is going to join here. Kind of this, but in this one I think it should be in this position. So if I am making anything in transparency, I can always change that so that I can modify it later, just like this. And then of course from this area I want to hide that. Okay, I think that much is done, that much is fine for me. Let's just make it. Okay, I'm going to select everything, go to object and expand appearance, then make them black. So this is how it is going to look right now. And you can see this part of the dinosaur should hide because the backpack belt is on from here. So kind of this. And there will be another part of the backpack here, but I'm not going to draw that right now, so don't worry. So this is how my dinosaur is looking right now with this backpack on. So I wanted to add something else more, like this football. So this is just an image of a football. You can find tons of them on Google. So I'm just tracing it. Just to give it a feel like that is going to play something like this. And that is fine. Copy this. I'm going to select this dinosaur, paste inside the transparency, merge, unite to make it one single shape. So you can see this is how it is looking right now, and I hope that will work for me. Okay guys, so my main graphic part is done here. So this is my dinosaur wearing a sunglass with the backpack on. So this is how it is looking right now. I'm going to add some color to it, because this kind of designs look good with different colors, because this is for kids, so kids love colors. And that is fine. I want to add some more elements. This is some vector pack from FreePix, so I wanted to use some of them, because you can see there are some elements that kids can relate, like this educational element, the pencil, the coloring brush, the bulb. So these are all this plus minus sign, because this is all related to education. So that's why I just wanted to use some of them. And from here, and of course this will help me generate the color ideas too for this kind of designs, something like this. Okay, so as you can see, this is a brush, right? So I can simply do some fun things here. This is the brush. Let's make it a custom brush. Okay, then I will be, I can simply make something like this. So I'm keeping the black part a group. Then if I take my brush tool, I can simply make a shape like this. Okay, so this is not looking very good, but I hope this will look good. I can change the color of the, I can change the size of the brush, but that is, let's keep it in the background. Okay, I'm erasing that for now. I will add that later, but for now I want to use some of these elements. Not in the face area, maybe this area. And then I'm going to okay, so sometimes these are just single object and I am going to make this a group. Cannot group the object. Okay, this is inside a group, so I need to, I don't know if that is a compound path or not. Let me check object, compound path, make, clipping mask, make. Okay, so that is not like that. I'm pressing Q, Q for lasso tool. And with lasso tool, I can simply select this one, cut, Ctrl V to paste, Ctrl G to group. And this is how it is looking right now. Okay, that is not working here. Okay, this is not a group. Okay, I'm just copying them. So this is how they are, pressing Shift X. That means I'm making their stroke to fill, and then I will create that them again. So I'm going to select them, picking some color for them, and then I'm going to add some stroke, maybe not that much, just a tiny bit, 3 pixels. So if I select this one and with eyedropper, if I click on that one, it will pick that one's color and size. So this is how it is going to look right now. I'm going to place some of these elements here. Okay, so I don't think that is good. So this is how it is looking right now. This is the final graphic position, not the final graphics. So I'm going to first of all take a rectangle here. Let's send that to back, and then if I select my this dinosaur group, I can press Shift M to erase this part. So you can see this is how my dinosaur is looking colorful, and I can do it in many different ways, but I wanted to just make it as simple as possible. So I'm going to select this yellow color and then erase that part, because that is going outside of my design area. And of course, what is going on here, I don't need that. So this is how it is looking right now. Now I want to change the color of the graphics, like the dinosaur one color, the backpack one color, sunglass another color, something like that. So for the base color, I'm going to pick this color for the dinosaur here, and then for the football, I want to change it to another color. So I'm going to take a ellipse here so that it matches the shape of the football in this. Then I'm going to make it yellow, cut it. Then if I select this blue and press Ctrl F, so it is going to paste my that shape in front of that blue shape. So you can see it is looking like this. That is fine. Now here I need to do some extra work here, because it's just drawn in this way. So for the backpack, I want to make that red color. So all I have to do is, I can simply draw a shape here. Just stay inside the drawing area of your main drawing, main design. So here, not like that. Okay, let's just do it in this way. So that looks fine. Now I just want to fill it with the rest of the design. maybe I will add this extra part, and then here make sure that you are staying inside the black area. So if I select this part of the design like this, I can deselect this part and this part. So only I have just this. Okay, so what is going on here? So I have this yellow cross selected, and how can you see that? I can see that here there is a yellow cross, you can see that is selected. So pressing shift and deselecting that, this is the red color only, cut it. Now I want to select this blue color and then press Ctrl F. So Ctrl F will paste that on top of that blue color but behind my black color. So you can see this is how it is being colorized. And for this area, of course, I wanted to, I will do that same thing, but here I'm selecting the blue color. I am going to erase some of the parts because this part is not supposed to be here. So I'm going to erase that. Now here I want to do the same thing. So this time let's do it with pen tool. So I'm going to select my pen tool, turn off this align to pixel. Pen tool takes a bit more time than pencil tool, but it makes it perfectly precise. There is another way of coloring, maybe a easy way of coloring, but not when the drawing is made with different parts. So right now I'm going to keep everything together, then join it. So this is the shape. Let's press Shift X and then let's make it red, cut it, select this shape, press Ctrl F. So this is how it is looking right now. And here I will be adding, I can simply select this red shape, and then here with my scissor tool, or sorry, the knife tool, I can make it cut from here. And that is going to give me a separate area of the main red design. Just like this. Okay, let's do it one more time. So I'm going to select this shape, and then I'll need to erase this part because that part I don't want. Or one more thing that I do here, that is I can simply take my pen tool again just to make a selection like this, not selection, just a shape like this. And there will be two things to do. So that shape is made. Let's select this shape, Ctrl C to copy. And then if I select this one, I can press minus front. So minus front will make it look like this, but don't worry, press Ctrl F again. And that shape, I want to make it yellow. And then here again, I'm going to select this one, cut, select it, Ctrl F, cut, select it, Ctrl F. So pasting everything in the background of that shape. Again, I am going to take my pen tool here, just like this. This is really a time taking work, guys. I don't know if you guys will watch it or not even. So let's copy that, select this shape, minus front, and then again, I'm going to press Ctrl, select this one, press Ctrl F, then select this one, cut, select it, Ctrl F. So this is how it is going to look right now. Or maybe I don't need this, just I don't need to do the minus front here. So this is the shape, cut it. I'm going to select this black shape, press Ctrl B. So it will be pasted in the back of the black shape. So you can see this is how it is looking right now. The dinosaur is looking a bit colorful. And then of course for the rest of the area like this nails, this part of the middle part of the dinosaur, I can also make them colorful. So let's try to do that. P pick any color you want. Okay, there is another way you can do this. I'm going to select them all, group it, then copy that. Let's take it to another artboard, and here I will be placing it like this. And then I'm going to take my magic wand tool to click on this black color, so it is going to select everything in black. And of course, if there is any more color, you can select that. Let me show you. Selecting them all, object, expand, expand again, so there is no stroke left. Let's make the stroke none. And then here I'm going to select this black color. Okay, maybe not everything is black here. Let's make it black and then cut it. So you can see only the colors are left here. Okay, sorry guys. So I need to again select this part of the black to cut it. So this is how it is looking. Let's take another layer on top of that and press Ctrl F here. So Ctrl F will make the black separate. So let's make it a group. So let's lock it. So my blacks are locked right now, and all the color you can see here is only the background color, the color that we placed in this layer. So I'm going to lock this layer too, and then inside that layer, in between these two layers, I'm going to create another layer. So in this layer, I will be adding the extra colors. Like I want to add some darker shapes to this nails. I can simply draw it like this, and you can see it is automatically going in the background of the black shape, because my that black shape is in the is on top of everything. So you can see this is really cool. And if I go inside something like that area, it will be visible. But if I stay inside this black shape and make it like this, it is going to work. Sometime it happens. Just delete it. So that part is looking good. It will take some time, but I am going to record everything, whatever I am doing here, so that you can learn. Yeah, so this is how it is looking. Okay, maybe the teeth, this also should be kind of that white. So that is, I am making it in detail because that original image was a Google search image, so that can be copyrighted. So if I make modifications like this, then it is easy, it is safe to use, because then no one can give me copyright strike, because this is becoming another image. Just keep in mind to stay inside the area of the black. So I'm going to pick this yellow color, taking my pencil tool again. I'm doing everything with mouse. So if you don't have a graphic tablet, do not limit yourself that you cannot do this. Okay, so like this. Okay, I think that is good, and there is still some areas that I wanted to make in different color. I'm not making it too many color, just some base colors, 2-3 colors. That's all for this design. Okay, I'm worried about the video is being recorded or not. So I think that is done. Now one more thing that I want to do here, that is make it from this area. If there is something missing, you can always fix that. Okay guys, so this is how it is looking right now. And of course, for this area, I wanted to do some variations here. and that is done. Okay, so this is how it is looking right now. I am okay with that. And here is one more thing, that if you want to add some shading to this design, you can do that. Let's lock this layer too and then create another layer. And this layer I want to create on top of these two color layer only, below the outline layer. And here I will be picking this base color of anything. Then I will take a darker shade of that color, and then I am going to take my pencil tool again to draw some shapes like this. Just wherever you feel like there should be some shadows, you can. And some shapes like this. Don't worry about how it is looking, if it is perfect or not. Just keep going. Make sure that you are not going inside any of the previous color area. Only stay inside the dark black area. And I think this will be a complete drawing tutorial for you. Wherever you feel like there should be some shadows because of the other elements or the overlapping of the light, something like that, you can put a shading there. Okay, so as you can see, this is the lower part of the mouth. So everything here should be inside the shadow because of the shadow of the upper part of the mouth. Something like this, not like that. Okay, and here there should be a shadow of the school bag belt like this, and then there should be shadow of this area. I made a mistake here, so I'm going to fix that. Okay, so that's how it is looking right now. Let's draw some shadows in this area, but not too big because the sunglass is small, so the shadow of it should be smaller too. Something like this. Okay, so like this, I think this is enough of the shadow part for the dinosaur. And then again, for any color you want, like this, for this backpack, I want to pick this color. Then I want to pick a darker shade of that color. Take the pencil tool again, draw some shapes like this. Okay, so I made a mistake here. This part should be this shade. That will look good, I think. So let's lock it, come back to this layer. And I'm going to make a bigger shadow here because of the position of the bag. Just like this. And that is fine. And here, I think it should be the biggest black or darker area, because I had some mistakes here. I didn't make it match with the bag very well. So there I can just simply make a shadow, and that will hide some of the parts. And of course, some shadows in this area. this is going beyond the face, so there should be some shadow of the face. Okay, so I think that much is done. Let's pick the yellow color and then pick the darker version of the yellow. I'm going to make a big shadow here because there should be less light. Kind of this. Okay. There is a tiny mistake in this area, so I will fix that. And the mistake is this. So if I pick this black color and make a shape here, it will hide that part. So guys, after making this much effort, so this is how my main graphic is looking right now. And then again, I am going to make that. Let's first of all ungroup everything, then select everything, make group. So this is how it is looking right now. This is my original design. Make a copy and then I'm going to place it here like this. And as I wanted to use this brush, I'm picking the brush tool with this brush, and then I will be using kind of this. I don't know if this is something, if this is a good idea or not. No, I don't think this is a good idea. Okay, just something of educational. And this is how it is looking. Cut it, Ctrl B to paste in back. So just in the background, and I think that is fine. Let's expand it. So this is how my design is looking right now, and I think this is a mistake. So I'm going to pick that color, make it yellow. That is fine. So this is my main design part. And then I am going to add some text to my design, and that is going to be this text. I am ready to crush kindergarten. Okay, so let's complete the design. I am not going to spend too many time adding the text here because my graphic part is really important. So I am going to add some random text here. I'm ready to crush. And here I will be using something like Jenda. This is the font name, Jenda Mantis. Jenda Manatee Solid or whatever the font name is. So that is the font name here I'm using because I wanted to use a kids looking font. So that's it. I want to make the kindergarten here. So just like this, very simple, ready to crush kindergarten. So I'm going to select it all, then I'm going to align the position because I want to make it all in the center, something like this. Then I'm going to make this part a bit smaller or just make it two part like the example, because this text is a bit longer, so that is making it okay. So kindergarten is, it should be look like this. Let's do something here. Something like that. Let's create outline, that means break the fonts, and then I'm going to make them a group. Then I'm going to bring this inside here, and then I'm going to put my text here. Let's break these two font, and then I will be moving some of the parts because this is hiding inside the. Okay, so here is the problem. This is grouped together. So I want to, I am pressing Q. Q means the lasso tool, and that's how I can select only that part, and then I can move it wherever I want. I am ready to crush. Then of course this one, it is also not looking good there. Okay, and then this, let's lock it so that I can select and cut this part of the design. Something like this, that is fine. Let's press Q to select that part. Let's make it a plus. So okay, not like that. Let's delete it. Okay, so I make them all in a group, so that's why I need to now select them with lasso tool to move them. So something like this, kindergarten. So I think this is fine. So that should be the width of my design, so I'm going to make it same size width, and that will give me the area where I want to put my designs. One, sorry, this is taking too long than expected time, because I'm making it in other style than I started. So in this one, I'm going to pick in this color, then this brush, I'm going to make it in this dinosaur color, I'm ready to in this yellow color. So that part is done. Let's select this one, and then I'm going to add some stroke to them, something like a black stroke, so that it looks visible, like on top of my dinosaur graphics, like this, something like that is fine. Let's select this one. Okay, if I select this one, that is 6 point stroke, I'm selecting this one. Let's make it 10 point stroke, and then this one I'm going to make it a bit smaller, because a stroke will give it a white 6 point stroke. So that much is fine for me. Let's say I want to, okay, I'm done for today. So no more things. Here is a little overlapping, so I need to fix it. Okay, one more thing and I'm done, and that is I have a brush here. So if I simply take my brush tool, make the stroke color white, I can simply paint some areas like this. Not that much big, a bit smaller areas, just to give it a highlighted style feel. So like this. I'm going to upload this on Amazon, so I'm going to spend some more time to make it as good as possible, as good as I can. So don't just copy and upload this to Amazon. Something like that, and then of course same thing here. This is a bigger text, so my stroke size should be little bigger, maybe 1.5 pixel point. Something like this. And then I will need to make it smaller because this area is small. There can be some unnecessary noise in today's video because my phone setup is, my microphone setup is not ready yet. Okay, so that's it. My design is ready. I'm going to make it a group all together, then I'm going to expand it, because I don't want any strokes left in the design. That much is done. Let's take the brush tool again, and I'm going to add some areas like this, because there are some empty space and I don't like that. Okay, so that is done. Let's group it. I'm going to expand it again, and then let's pick a black background and see how it is looking right now. So yeah, this is how it is looking. So you can see the black is not visible here on top of black, but it is making my design stand out from the original graphics. So that black was just to make it stand out on the graphics part here. And maybe I can simply do a little bit more modifications here. Sorry about that. So here, and then not this one. Okay, let's not do that. So this is how it is looking right now, and I hope you will learn something new from this one, how to modify designs, how to make a unique cool looking designs. And if you learn something new, let me know in the comment section, and let me know if I should make this kind of designs regular or not. So I'm really happy with the output here. That's it for today's video, guys. See you in the next video. Have a great time. Thank you, everyone. Thank you very much.